Today we are doing a photo shoot. We're shooting in a cemetery. So we're going to wait for the sun to come up because we're a bunch of scary people. And let's see, we're going to meet the makeup artist and hairstylist on location. And of course, the most important thing besides bringing your camera is bringing the model. So first thing in the morning, go get the model. We're going to see how it goes from there. Are you almost awake?
Yes. All right, ready great. For our
we're going to head to the location now. See you there. So here we are on our way to location. Like a genius, I picked a cemetery downtown, which means we're fighting downtown traffic. This is nothing because there is actual movement. There's kinetic energy because we are smack dab in the most dangerous stretch of highway in the nation, I-35. I'd like to point out that this stretch of highway was designed by an Aggie who eventually committed suicide. True, it's a fact. And I would too, because, Jesus. Yeah. Anyways, we're a few exits away from the location. Just got a call from the stylist, Tavia Williams. Tavia? I need to learn that.
Yeah, you sure do.
I'm gonna pull the whole, I'm Joe, nice to meet you, and like let her introduce herself.
Yeah.
So, as you can see, I've got skills. I know how to like fake an intro. And, yeah, we'll be there shortly. And, next time you see us, we'll have young Miss Katherian getting her hair did.
Getting my hair done first.
Well, the hairstylist is there first, so I think she deserves first dibs. Oh wait, no, that's the makeup artist. More coffee. What's fun about shooting on location is nothing works. At some point, something, if not everything, is going to break, fail, go to sleep on you. This time, it was my power inverter, so the girls have no power. I've got a hairstylist over there working with nothing but her skill and the old school trade of comb, tease, and spray. We have no iron, we have no chi flattener, but Anna is a pro, she's a trooper. Like I said, this is all about people's, you know, with great work ethic that I was able to empower and recruit and scout and beg and plead and grovel to come out and help us with this shoot. So yeah, we're going through with the shoot manually, a true bootstrap shoot. But we're not deterred. We're still gonna get this on. And what's amazing is that we're on time. We will probably not be more than an hour late. And for remote shooting, that's amazing to be less than an hour late or right at an hour late. It pushes back the shoot we have coming up behind it. More on that later. It's a pirated shoot. It'll change the dynamics of how we're going to have that shot. But it's okay. I'm still confident. The model's looking great. Great isn't scary. The Dia de Los Muertos shot is very important to me. It's a competition shoot, not only for my class, but it's also, I want to take it down to several areas. There's a jury selection in San Antonio that I want to present this series to. And, iconic art is very important to the Catholics. My family is Catholic. My girlfriend Bethany is Catholic. She's big into iconic art. And a lot of her influence kind of inspired me to shoot this. A lot of the stuff that she wanted in her home as a designer inspired me to shoot this. This fall, I hope to really make an impact on what's going on as far as art-wise in the Mexicultural environment. With this series. Dia de los Muertos has always been a very popular global event. It's very artistic. It's somewhat misrepresented in some cultures, or misunderstood, I should say, by some cultures. It's a great celebration, and it's festive, it's fun, it celebrates what was and what has become from previous lives and livelihoods. And it's great to see this kind of formulate and watch it slowly come from a couple of guys with a couple of cameras and a couple of makeup artists to hopefully a great piece of art in the middle of the day in the heat of the summer in Austin, Texas. So, yeah, we'll see if it works out. We'll be right back. how we do it. Roll into the cemetery, which is actually, there was a logistical error on my part. Imagine that. This happens a lot when you're kind of slapping this thing together. The cemetery has actually been open this entire time. However, the curfew doesn't allow people in before 8. And so just to kind of be careful and cover my ass, we didn't come in here before 8. Hopefully this will help reduce the risk of getting kicked out. Some people would consider this, misinterpret this as less than respectful. A lot of people don't understand the Dia de Los Muertos is a celebration that is actually, you know, about the lives that have passed. And this is the perfect setting, and this is a beautiful thing we're doing. But again, this is a pirated shot. When I say pirated, I mean we're kind of poaching on the area. The sprinklers have just started. So we're going to film from the edge of the graveyard and kind of shoot into it. And yeah, should be good. I've got my assistant, Amy Smith, riding the shotgun behind me. And the hairstylist is following us over.
And
the MUA is probably going to show up too. We're going to do touch-ups once Katherian is in uniform costume. And I think that this is a nice little patch of shooting area we can use that I'm going to pull up to right here. And it appears that if I park here, I won't actually be covering anyone's grave.
Are you sure?
I'm not sure.
Because...
All right, here we go.
Llega sin esta manera, no tiene la culpa. Caballo le dan sabana, porque muy despreciado.
Look
por eso,
no te
redondo llorar. Ese amor llega sin esta manera, no tiene la culpa. Amor de compraventa, amor del pasado. Ven, 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 ven. Perdón de Dios, tú eres mi vida, la fortuna del destino. El destino te desaparado, lo mismo ya callé, lo mismo soy yo. No te encuentro lavando, eres posible, no te encuentro de verdad. Por eso un día no cuento si de nada, lo mismo ya callé, lo pienso en ti. Bambolea, bambolea, porque mi vida yo la prefiero vivir así. Bambolea, bambolea, porque mi vida yo la prefiero vivir así. Vamos.